Okay, here's a quick reminder of what we've been doing last week. We have sine, cosine, and tan, which is O over H for sine. Cosine is A over H, and tan is O over A. And remember, we have three sides, and we need to label each of them every time we have a triangle. So, hypotenuse being the longest side, O being the one opposite the given angle, and adjacent being the third one. So, remember, hypotenuse the longest side, whatever side is opposite the angle that's marked is the O for opposite, and then A, the last one, is adjacent. And it doesn't matter if the triangle is upside down or sideways or whatever. The longest side is always the hypotenuse, and the side that's opposite the marked angle is always the O for opposite. And then the remaining one being the adjacent, or adjacent being beside the angle. Right, so here's what I want you to do. I want everyone in the class to take out their copies, and I want you to take down each of these triangles. What you'll see is that they're all right angle triangles with one angle marked in them. I want you to label which is hypotenuse, which is the opposite, and which is the adjacent, with a H, A, or an O. Okay, also last week we looked at finding the missing side when we were given an angle and a side. So here we have a flagpole. And the flagpole is the angle of elevation is 48 degrees. The bottom of the line from the flagpole is 10 meters away from the pole. And we have to find the height of the flagpole. Okay, so 48 degrees. So here we go. We know that what? Well, which is O, which is H, and which is A? We certainly know that the line is H. The O is opposite the 48. And the A is the 10 meters. So we have the adjacent and we're looking for the opposite. So which of our sine, cosine, or tan has O and A in it? Is it sine? O over H? No. Is it cosine? A over H? No. So it must be tan. O over A. Yeah, because we're looking for O and we have A. So we know that it's tan and the angle, 48, is equal to O, the opposite, which is X, we don't know, over A, 10 meters. Remember, when we have a number on the bottom, we bring it over to the left-hand side and multiply it so that it's 10 times tan 48 is equal to x. And that's how we find out the height of the flagpole. In this case, the height of x. Work that out in your calculators and copy this question down in your copy. Okay, here's another question. A ladder is placed against a wall at a 60 degree angle. Find the length of the ladder. So we have a diagram here. The ladder is 1.8 meters away from the wall at its base. And it's at an angle of elevation of 60 degrees. Now, this time you're not asked to find the height of the wall. You're asked to find the length of the ladder. So take down this question and the diagram. All right, here's how we did it. And it's slightly different to the way we've done the last question because we were looking for something different. We know the hypotenuse and we know the adjacent, which means we're dealing with cosine, A and H. Cosine 60 equals 1.8 over H. This time it's a letter on the bottom of the fraction. And instead of bringing the H over and multiplying it by cos, we swap cos 60 with the H. So the hypotenuse is equal to 1.8 over cosine 60. Or 1.8 divided by cosine 60. Work that out on your calculators, take the question down, and fill it in. And your answer should be 3.6. Okay, so you have two questions. Take this down and work it out, and then for homework, take this down and work it out.